the banana, Hannah. Try the salami, Tommy. Give it the gravy, Davy. Everybody eats when they come to my house.
Hey guys, it's Jodi here with Honeysuckle Hill Bee-stro, and for this week's cooking guest, we have our firstborn, Judah, the one who made me a mother. Isn't that sweet?
It sure is.
So a lot of you may not see Judah in the bistro, but she's there every Friday and Saturday, unless the rare occasion that you take the weekend off to go someplace or something.
I have friends, I have a life.
Yeah. Okay, so anyway, she's usually in the kitchen, and for the first pretty much almost full 3 years, you've been a dishwasher. Because you were kind of hiding. But I always knew that she could be a cook because she cooks at home. She's like she's my right hand whenever it comes to cooking. And so I knew she could do it. So towards the last half of last year, you started cooking. Mm-hmm. And I think you surprised yourself.
Yeah, because I was kind of like nervous, like I was going to mess everything up because there's like, I think like 30 servings of each food that we make. Mm-hmm. So, like I was kind of nervous, like what if I screw this entire thing up and then we're out 30 of this thing. So, I'm like, I don't know.
But you
it was easy once I got good.
Yeah. And Judah actually does make better mashed potatoes than what I do. So,
it's called rosemary.
So, yeah, she'll sneak some other stuff in that I don't normally sneak in. So.
I sneak in a lot of spices, actually.
Yeah, she does. So, Judah, you've been cooking ever since you were just a little tiny tot.
Yeah, there's pictures of me in the kitchen in not so good ways.
Yeah, there's one picture where you don't have anything on your behind, and
I just had an apron.
But you had an apron on, so
it was comfortable.
And you were little.
You have to be comfortable in the kitchen, or you're not going to make good food.
That's true. So what's the first thing you remember cooking?
Okay, so I remember one time. I don't even know how I got the idea in my head, but I remember one time I got all the ingredients together to make a loaf of bread, and I got it, and I had this little toy plastic kitchen.
It was a little tight.
Yeah, and it had the fridge and all that stuff that normal kids' kitchens have. And so I put all the ingredients in the sink, and I mixed it up in the sink part. And then I think I might have gotten you up to help me put it in the bread tin or something. And then we baked it, and it was actually bread. It was good.
It was good. It was impressive, and you totally made up the recipe yourself. Yeah.
Was Sophie even born then?
No.
So I was maybe younger than four.
Yeah. So I was probably taking a nap because I was pregnant with Sophie. So anyway.
Yeah.
So you've been cooking for a long, long time, and it's kind of easy, second nature to you. And one of the things that you enjoy making is cinnamon rolls.
Yeah, I figured that everybody should have a thing that they're absolutely perfect at making, they're really, really good at making and enjoy making. So, I don't know why, but it just got in my head. I have to make cinnamon rolls really, really good. So, I think I made a batch of cinnamon rolls at least once a week, every week. And I think I got a bunch of people sick of cinnamon rolls, but I got it. I've got good cinnamon rolls now. I brought them to work and they called them diabetes bread.
Oh. So today we're going to be making our family's version of soup beans and cornbread.
Yeah.
I mean, every family has a staple. Yeah. Every Hoosier family probably has a staple recipe that they use for soup beans.
I remember as a kid, I didn't like soup beans. It was one of the top three meals that I absolutely dreaded. I
top hated, three meals.
Yes, because they're very specific. Like, I know it's your favorite meal, but green beans, potatoes, and ham are your absolute favorite meal. But it's like, it probably is the number one least favorite for me. But like,
sorry about that.
Yeah, you ate a lot growing up. And, like, that probably didn't help. But once we figured out how we make it, like, now I kind of crave it now. Because we'll have soup beans at work and stuff in our cafeteria, and I'm like, I can't eat that. That's not ours. That's not as good as ours. So.
Yeah. Yeah. So we do, I mean, we put the cornbread in, and we make our own cornbread, and that's going to be what it is that you show today. Because you make the cornbread 9 times out of 10.
Yeah.
So Jude is our cornbread maker. So, and then I cooked the soup beans actually on top of the wood stove in the living room.
Yeah.
So, you know, whenever it's a cool day, I like to put on top of our wood burner, you can make that like a stove. And so I like to cook soup on top of the wood burner because it's just kind of fun. And I, you know, for like a more angles or something. But anyway, and then we do something crazy. We put slaw on top of the soup beans, which is on top of the cornbread, and then we top it with
jalapeno pepper jelly.
And the jalapeno pepper jelly is like the bomb of the
tea. That's why it like ties it all together, because it's got a bang. It's like it pops in your mouth and it's good.
That's right. So we've had people like you that have been here as guests when we've had this, and they've said, I don't like soup beans, but then they try it and then they love it. So so it's pretty simple, and it looks, it doesn't look appealing in the bowl.
No, it doesn't.
But it's good.
But it's delicious. It's not about how it looks, it's about how it tastes.
That's right. That's true. So do you remember the time in our life before we had jalapeno pepper jelly in it?
No.
No?
It was a dark time. It's crazy.
Well, you were little then, too. Probably.
Because I remember it being at, like, holiday parties, and people would bring it in and put it on cream cheese and eat it with crackers. I remember liking that, too.
Yeah. So, the first time we ever had it, it was before Sophie was born. Man, we had, like, a full life before Sophie was born. But, anyway, we had a pastor at the time that he and his wife brought over a jar of it. And, I mean, you're, like, under 5 years old, and you just kept on coming for more jalapeno pepper jelly. And it was, like, I was kind of nervous, because here you are, you're a little gal, and you're eating, you know, something spicy and hot.
Yeah.
But we use that really quite a bit in a lot of recipes, don't we?
Yeah. And, when we developed the habanero honey, that was really good, too, because spicy things are good. I'm sorry, it just is.
Yeah. But especially when you add sweet to it, then the jelly and the jalapeno pepper jelly and the honey and the habanero honey, so. Okay, so, I almost forgot to ask you, what do you feel like your creative outlet is?
I don't know, because I'm kind of a jack of all trades. Like, I'm good at a little bit of everything. So, like, once I figure out, like, oh, I can make wooden pins, or I can paint pretty well.
You need to make more wooden pins.
I know. Like, I got it mostly finished. I know I can do it.
I know. You need to make more. So a couple years ago, Andy, for Christmas, got Judah an attachment for the wood lathe so she can make wooden pins. And she made a couple, and they were really good. Mm-hmm. And you are a good painter.
Yeah. Like, I did the Lincoln painting. I did a couple Lincoln paintings. I'm good at a little bit of everything. I don't know what I'm good at, though.
Yeah.
I used to be a really good writer, though, and I wish I kept up with that.
Yeah. Okay, so join us in the kitchen while Judah makes cornbread, and then I'll show you how we assemble our little soup bean bowl whenever we get the cornbread out of the oven. Judah jumped the gun before we started rolling the cameras. So,
The butter's already in our mixer, along with the sugar. So you want to tell them how much of each you put in?
I put in a cup of sugar, and I put in 2/3 of a cup of softened butter.
Yeah, so it wasn't melted, it was just softened.
So you're going to whip that until creamy. Okay.
While you're doing that, I'm going to measure out the cornmeal that we're going to need.
I'm adding 3 eggs.
3 eggs.
And then I'm going to scrape down the sides for you, add 3.
So I'm trying to get the bottom because sometimes, like, I know. Finished product still has like sugary buttery stuff at the bottom.
I know. So, okay, I gotta tell you, sometimes I'm just not smitten with my mixer in the house because I know it's a KitchenAid, it's supposed to be wonderful, blah, 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 blah. But anyway, it doesn't get down to the bottom. If anybody has a remedy for that, hey, hit me up. Okay, I'm ready
for the last egg.
All right, so Judah, what are we adding next?
We're adding buttermilk, which you can make at home with butter and white vinegar. You just need 1 cup of milk and 1 tablespoon tablespoon of white vinegar to get it like that. But we're using...
We've adjusted.
It's actually 1 cup and 2/3, so adjusted accordingly. I'm not going to do your math. You could do that.
She doesn't math.
I don't math in my head.
So did you notice when that milk went in, it kind of plopped? If you don't have white vinegar, if you've got lemon juice does the same thing in making buttermilk.
And if you don't have lemon juice or vinegar, then you can just do milk. It really doesn't matter, but I prefer buttermilk.
Yeah, the original recipe just calls for milk, but Judah, you know, every cook has to put their own little spin on things, so that's Judah's spin.
Alright.
So now what are we doing?
Now we're adding our dry goods.
Okay.
1 cup of cornmeal and 2 2/3.
1/3.
1/3, okay, good.
Cool. Double checking her. Don't want to make it too dry. And what is that you're adding?
Flour.
Okay. just regular flour. Yeah. All-purpose flour. Nothing fancy. So how much baking powder?
4.5 teaspoons. I know what I mean in my head. It just doesn't come out too good.
Judah, when would you eat cornbread besides soup beans? Eating up with soup beans.
Well, to quote Fred Astaire from Holiday Inn, it's good even or even plain. So.
Because you have made it before, just, you know, not for dinner or anything. You've mixed it up and baked it just for fun.
Yeah. And
you need help with that.
Yes. Thanks.
I don't like this mixer, folks. No. Okay. Sorry. Switching sides.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I've also made it as pancakes, so, and I recommend that.
See, I've never had it as pancakes. Where have I been? Whenever you have...
Probably to the store or something.
Do you put, like, syrup on them and stuff? Or what do you do?
You can. It's good with just butter, but I also, like, put syrup, but I can also put, like,
corn syrup?
Corn syrup, yes. Oh, my gosh. That was difficult. I'm sorry.
Corn syrup on your corn pancakes.
Yes.
That's... Sounds corny. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, I should probably spray that pan for you.
Yes.
This is a 9x13 pan that we are using. It's going to be going into a 350 degree oven for 22 to 27 minutes. So, Judah, what are we going to try to set the oven? How many minutes are we going
to try? 22 to 27. I like it, my cornbread to be slightly more moist, so less is more.
I agree. All right, we're going to put this in a 350 degree oven. We're going to set the timer for 22 minutes, and we're going to check it then. Okay, so the cornbread's done, and we've got our soup beans over here on the counter. Judah's going to be putting the soup beans on the cornbread, and while she's doing that, I'm going to make up the slaw dressing, which I just have some mayo, and you guys, I'm not even going to give you measurements on this because I don't know. It's trial and error. I put a little bit of apple cider vinegar in it. I do a little bit of a jalapeno pepper jelly and a little bit of salt. Or not, that's not salt. I'm sorry, that's sugar. And I'm gonna just kind of mix this together. And I was kind of, you know, I'll be honest, there's a lot of things you can do in life. And shredding cabbage is not one of the things I want to spend my life doing. So, okay, now let's just throw this slaw mix in here. This is a pretty small bag too, actually, the slaw mix. That salad dressing all over the slaw mix. I think I've got it all mixed together. So, Judah, do we have forks to taste this with? All right, we better grab some. Okay, so what we do here at the Lorman household, we put our slaw right on top. And then Judah, you do the crowning glory on it.
You want more salt?
No, that's all right. Okay, so this is what it looks like, but it's better when I remix it all together. So sorry, it's gonna look like a hot mess here in a second. I feel like I'm gonna be a really messy eater eating this on camera. You guys, try soup beans the Lorman family way. Mm-hmm. We do sell in the bistro jalapeno pepper jelly. Sometimes you may see it may be a five pepper jelly, but it's still got that spice in it and that sweet heat. Mm-hmm. And it will change your life. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Facebook, sign up for our emails, get all the stuff so you can be in the know, everything bistro.